Good evening, everybody. This is Mark again here at the National Weather Service in Norman, Oklahoma. How about an updated briefing on what to expect Saturday and Sunday in terms of severe weather? We're still looking at the potential for severe storms beginning late Saturday afternoon or early evening and continuing through the overnight hours. The initial focus for storm development will be over southwestern Oklahoma and western North Texas, where better moisture and instability will make for a favorable severe storm environment. Storm coverage will initially be sparse, and we may only see one or two storms develop at first. Initial storms will hold the greatest potential for very large hail up to baseball size and damaging winds approaching 75 miles per hour. In addition, we may also see a tornado threat with these storms. This is kind of an odd event in that the potential for tornadoes will actually increase from around sunset through around 10 p.m. Therefore, you should not let your guard down once it gets dark. We could still be dealing with tornadoes for an hour or two after the sun goes down. Don't be scared, just make sure you know where you will take cover and check the batteries in those weather radios in case you lose power. Storms will most likely become more widespread from 10 p.m. through midnight, and virtually any storm that develops will have the potential to produce large hail and damaging winds. Now, the tornado threat should diminish later in the evening, but a very low tornado potential may exist through the overnight hours depending on several factors that are still very unclear. Again, you don't need to stay up all night and be fearful. Getting prepared now will put your mind at ease and ensure your safety. Scattered strong to severe storms will be present right into Sunday morning. The greater potential will exist along and west of the I-35 corridor. This means there may be strong to severe storms in the area at the start of the Oklahoma City Marathon. All individuals involved in this event or any other morning or early afternoon events on Sunday should closely monitor conditions. We probably won't have a good handle on exactly what will happen Sunday morning until sometime Saturday night, so check the forecast frequently and make sure you have some way to receive weather warnings, whether it be on a cell phone or a portable weather radio. After midnight, the main hazards will transition to hail and wind. Lightning will be of a particular concern with any outdoor activities Sunday or Sunday afternoon. The dry line should move east rather quickly Sunday morning, bringing an end to severe weather chances over much of western Oklahoma. However, there still remains some uncertainty with respect to how far east this boundary may move during the day. Right now, areas along and east of I-35 look to maintain at least some chance of severe storms from late morning through mid to late afternoon. Most of the more significant severe storms should remain over far eastern Oklahoma, northeastern Texas, northern Louisiana, and Arkansas on Sunday. For information specific to those areas, you may want to visit individual National Weather Service webpages for those locations. I will list them on the final slide of this briefing. Again, we'll be looking at large hail, damaging winds, and possibly some tornadoes, although the greater threat will exist to the east of our area. Remember, don't be scared, be prepared. Have a plan and stay weather aware. If you're attending any of the numerous events going on across the region this weekend, you'll want to pay very close attention to the forecast. Check that phone app, favorite TV network, or local weather service page before you head out the door. Make sure you have some way to receive severe weather information, such as a cell phone, portable weather radio, or portable television. Okay, maybe not a portable television. Ask those running the events where you can shelter in the event severe weather impacts your area. Always have multiple ways to receive warnings. And don't wait for outdoor warning sirens to alert you to an impending hazard. They are not intended for people indoors. Thanks again for watching. As always, the best place to find the most accurate and up-to-date forecast and warning information for western and central Oklahoma and western North Texas is our webpage at www.weather.gov/norman. You may also wish to view forecasts and warnings for other areas that can expect severe weather this weekend, including Dallas-Fort Worth, Tulsa, Little Rock, and Shreveport. We also hope you'll like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks again, stay safe, and have a great weekend.